Also, I must also welcome the Secretary to the State Government, Tokunbo Talabi. I must welcome you to this place. The Deputy Chief of Staff is also here. Sir, our home also is a pastor, and we duly recognize you, sir. Please permit me to, of course, my good friend, the Senator Ugo Central, Senator Shaib. We welcome you very much, sir. I'm sorry. Thank you very much. We are glad to have you. Please, all of our recognitions will follow later. But please, let's continue the service now.
Praise the Lord. Like I said yesterday, our own KBAC, Oba Professor Saka Machemilola, the Oluyalo first, and the Oti letter seventh, was decorated yesterday as a fellow in the oldest institution, in the state. And KBAC here represented by the one of the Chief Olushola Adeoye, the Oshukwari, and other chiefs from Okeagowu. Let's celebrate them, please. Let's KBAC. The time is coming to recognize and appreciate every other dignitaries. So please, let's stop by that, Excellencies and Royal Highnesses. Thank you, God bless you. So the secretary will come later and the family to pick every other person. Thank you. The Boy Scout, 2 minutes.
Thank you. Praise the Lord. Presently, we are the Scout Association of Nigeria. Praise the Lord. I, Pastor Olutunji Bamidele Akisoya, leader trainer, the Ogun State Scout Council. I am here on behalf of the Ogun State Scout Council to pay a farewell be to our father.
Thank you. Please, sorry, the Highnesses, we have the paramount ruler of Egbaland, the representative of Ababa, Alake of Egbaland. Please, let's appreciate him. Let's say KBAC. And we have the Oshile of Okeona represented here too. Let's say KBAC. Thank you.
As I've rightly said, on behalf of Ogun State Scout Council, we are here to pay our last respect to our late father, the former State Scout Commissioner, Dr. Onolapo Osuleye. While he was alive, he taught us so many things. And today, I will remind us one out of the things he taught us. He used law number 10 that says, a scout is clean in thought, in word, and in deed. So he turned that law into a song, in which my other co-leaders will join me to sing that song today. The sing goes thus. Kose shen la ra win, kose shen la ra wa, be shen shen ba wa la ra yin, kose shen la ra mi. So be, kose shen la, kose shen la ra wa, be shen shen ba wa la ra re, kose shen la ra wa. Now, onti baba ko wa ni bene pe, agboro je olooto, ninu oro, ninu iwa, ati ninu ise. Eko to po la kolara baba wa late Dr. Onolapo Osuleye. Loni lorilede Nigeria gege bi on ti fi ko wa e je ka je olooto nibi kibi ta ba wa agboro je olooto ko si gba ta ma ma soro nipa scout ta ni daruko awon baba wa agba ni orilede Nigeria ti won wa nbi loni awon ni baba wa agba ti awon na ni aso yi scout bi mo se wo scout yi awon ni baba wa ti mo fe towo daruko won
Olusegun Aremu Obasanjo mo mo pe won se joko yen inu won dun si wa lokan pe awon ni awon omo to wa leyin adupe lowo yin baba fun ise te fi le wa lowo ke se be nikan awon baba wa wa n bi ti mi le daruko won ton gomina wa ti won je patron scout ni ipinle ogun Dr. Dapo Abiodun awon na je patron wa ni ipinle ogun so mo ke yin na ko abo so e se pupo o mo de n lo akoko yin lati ki mama ti baba wa fi sile pe ojo yin adale o leyin isikun baba ile yin aroju ona yin araye o. Once again, I want to appreciate this church, the council, the executive, the minister of God. We appreciate you for recognizing the Scout Association of Nigeria, Ogun State Scout Council. Thank you very much, and God bless you all.
Because of other engagement that the governor will have to attend to, we'd like to invite the Honorable Minister of Finance to come speak to us, and after him, the governor will come and address us. So let's celebrate the Honorable Minister of Finance, Honorable Wale Edun. Please, let's welcome him. Let's welcome him. So,
thank you, and good morning, church. Praise the Lord. His Excellency, the former president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, President Olusegun Obasanjo, GCFR. His Excellency, Prince Dapo Abiodun, Governor of Ogun State. Your Excellencies, the former governors, Governor Otumba Gbenga Daniel, Governor Senator Ibikunle Amosun, members of the National Assembly here present, particularly my own senator, Senator for Ogun Central, Senator Shuaib Salisu. Kabiyesi, our traditional rulers, particularly the Alake and Paramount ruler of Egba land, ably represented by the Osi Egba Chief Bode Mustafa, the members of Ogun State Government here present, and we have the COS, Chief of Staff, as well as the SSG, distinguished, all other protocols observed, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. It is an auspicious coincidence. Here I am, a son of Abeokuta, with the honor and privilege of holding the high office of Minister of Finance and Coordinating Minister of the Economy. And here we have before us the former Minister of Finance, a truly illustrious son of Abeokuta. And I remember very well at that time, 1983-84. Of course, it was December 31st, 83. And when it was announced that Dr. Onolapo Soleye was the Minister of Finance, I remember one of his first statements. It was about the IMF. We are in church. The words are unprintable in church that he had to say about them. And so many years later, I won't say, because we are in church, what I said about and to the IMF and some of their policies, prescriptions for Nigeria, and on what we thought of them and how negatively we thought of them. But I will admit this, my language was not as colorful as that of my illustrious predecessor who lies before us now. But we were of the same mind. What is good for Nigeria is what is uppermost in our minds, not what IMF or any other foreign organization thinks. prescriptions for Nigerians, by Nigerians, and by God's grace, under the able leadership of President Bola Ahmed Tinubu, we will move forward with this economy. Nigerians will smile again, and very soon. I don't want to turn this into a economic analysis session, but may I say that Dr. Onolapo Osoyeye, he did resolve or start the beginning of the resolution of the trade crisis. We had trade debts, and through his skill, his imagination, and his tenacity, that situation was resolved with initiatives that he himself implemented. And of course, government is a continuum, others carried on. By happy coincidence, when he was the Minister of Finance, his niece, the adorable Adetutu, was my colleague at Chase Merchant Bank in those days. So I had that connection with him through his niece. And I must say that I have tremendous respect for all that Dr. Osoyeye achieved, and my sincere condolences to his family that he has left behind. Olorun a te won si afefe rere. Eyin won a da o. Ami. Thank you very much.
Praise the Lord. At this time, we want to welcome the number one citizen to this pulpit. I would like us to rise. Those of us here and those at the basement, please rise as we welcome the number one citizen, His Excellency Prince Dapo Abiodun, MFR CON. Let's celebrate him as he comes to address us.
Please be seated. Your Excellency, our leader, our father, the man who repositioned Nigeria and came at a time when Nigeria needed to be rescued. The only, or rather the first, three-term president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. The Balogun of Owu, Chief Olusegun Aremu Okikiola Obasanjo GCFR, and his adorable wife, Mrs. Bola Obasanjo. The Honorable Minister of Finance and Coordinating Minister of the Economy, my brother, another illustrious son of Ogun State, Mr. Wale Edo. I was at an event with Baba Basojo 2 days ago. And one of my colleague governors asked me, why is it that every brilliant person in Nigeria is from Ogun State? So last night at the wakekeeping, I had to ask Baba, I said, Baba, I want to ask you a question that I was asked 2 days ago or yesterday. He said, what is the question? And I asked him. So next time they ask you that question, tell them there is special water that we drink in Ogun State that makes us very brilliant. Today we have the Honorable Minister of Finance here, and we have his predecessor also here with the former President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, among several stars that we have arrayed here today. His Excellency, my predecessor, Senator Ebukele Amosu. His Excellency, his predecessor, Senator Tumba Gbenga Daniel. Distinguished Senator representing Ogun Central Senatorial District, Senator Shoaib Afolabi Salisu. His Excellency, former Ambassador to the United Kingdom, Ambassador Sharaf Atunji Ishola. The matriarch of the Sholeye family, a wife of Dr. Olusegun Onolapo Sholeye, Chief Mrs. Modupe Sholeye. The children of our papa, I will use Lamide as a point of regards to love you, the grandchildren, great-grandchildren, and other family members. Members of the Ogun State Executive Council that are here present, led by the Secretary of State of Government, Mr. Togumbo Talabi, my Deputy of Staff is also here. We have several elder statesmen that are here this morning to bid Baba farewell. I will use Baba, Chief Dodge Adewolu, and his beautiful wife, retired Justice Adewolu, as a point of regards to all elder statesmen that are here. The OC is here representing the Olowu, I believe. Oh, Alake, representing the Alake. I think, is OC still here? OC. Okay, all right, very good, very good. At this point, let me also appreciate and thank the men of God who officiated over the Christian Waykeeping yesterday, and today they are here again officiating and superintending over this meeting. Let me start by thanking the President of the Ogun Baptist Conference, Reverend Dr. Oyewole Oyeni. So thank you very much, sir. Reverend Dr. Abraham Adewole, Reverend Dr. DSO Tinoye, Reverend Dr. Josiah Adeshope. I believe that it must be a requirement in the Baptist ministry that you have to have a PhD for you to be a pastor. Reverend Francis Umokoro and all other clergy that are here present, this very beautiful choir, all other distinguished guests, gentlemen of the press, ladies and gentlemen, it's a pleasure for me to be here this morning, to be part of this beautiful service in sending forth an illustrious son of this country, a proud son of Ogun State, and of course, and a woman. I could not be more proud to be the governor of a man with such a rich heritage. Baba started his educational career, his secondary school, he went to Baptist Boys High School, and from there he did very well. He decided that he wanted to advance his education, worked very hard, saved, did the West African Education Council exam, because he had to pass that to go to school in England. He wanted to go to the prestigious London School of Economics, and he passed and was accepted into the prestigious LSE. Whilst he was there, having studied and gotten a diploma in LSE, But I went further. After he was asked to study statistics, which he didn't think he had that much strength in, opted to go to the prestigious University of Manchester. The University of Manchester, Papa did his bachelor's, did his master's, and went back to do his PhD. This PhD he did having been given a scholarship by the Ford Foundation. He came back to Nigeria. He had a stint at the Nigerian Institute for Social and Economic Research in Ibadan. But his quest to be a lecturer and to be known as a scholar eventually saw him lecturing in the prestigious University of Ibadan. Baba was a gentleman. But as gentle as he was also an activist. From all accounts, he was a black nationalist. Like Labide had said, Baba believed in the cause and shared the values of Malcolm X and began to propagate the beliefs of Malcolm X in terms of ensuring that he fought for the rights of the black people. He did this while he was in university, propagated this while he was in UI. He was serving in UI as a lecturer when his brother and friend appointed him to be the Honorable Minister, Honorable Commissioner for Industries of the then, you know, Western region. He served as the Honorable Commissioner for Industries under the then Major General Jembeon, who was the governor of the Western region. And during Baba's watch as Honorable Commissioner for Industries, he ensured that he birthed the creation of what we now know today as Odua Investment Group. Because he was very particular that it was important for the new states that were coming up there from the Western region, the Oyo, Ogun, and Ondo states, to have a rancor-free collaboration and cooperation. Baba later left the Western region when Ogun State was created and became one of the first commissioners in Ogun State. Baba was appointed to be the commissioner for the then Trade and Industries. It was then called Trade, Industries, and Cooperatives. He was the first commissioner of Ogun State for Trade, Industries, and Cooperatives. Later, he became the commissioner for Works and Housing in Ogun State, and then eventually became the commissioner for Finance in Ogun State. So Baba served as Commissioner for Industries for the Western Region, came to his home state to serve as Commissioner for Industries and Trade, Commissioner for Works, and Commissioner for Finance. Most people may not realize the fact that it was under Baba's watch as Commissioner for Industries that the Ogun State Gateway Hotel was constructed and commissioned. It's very clear to me that the history of this state and that of Baba is very, very closely intertwined. Baba was later appointed and served as the Honorable Minister for Finance under the immediate past President, General Muhammad Buhari, between 1984 and 1985, like the CME just explained to us. And as Honorable Minister of Finance, a proud Owu son, a proud Ogun State son, fought, resisted the devaluation of the Naira. He ensured that the Naira was not devalued. It was under his watch that new notes were printed when, at the point in time, there was this trend of currency smuggling. And I'm saying all these things because, you know, it is important that we all appreciate the life of impact that this man, this humble man, this gentleman, this man who was extremely well educated, this man who was very highly principled, this man who was a man of integrity, a man who was extremely forthright by all accounts that we've had this morning and all that we know. This man that we all know and everybody refers to as Baba Obasanjo's friend. And you know that you can only be Baba Obasanjo's friends if you have some certain qualities like this. Baba Okinba Ule Shore. Baba Okinba Etoban Shotutoshu Shore. So when they say someone is Baba, when Baba was president, I was privileged to have been Baba's son from when he was in office. And Baba Chole was one of those that we would go and talk to. If we ask and tell Baba something and Baba doesn't want to listen, we know that if we tell Baba Chole, because of the absolute respect that Baba has for Baba Odulapo Chole. Again, besides all this, Baba was a God-loving, a God-serving man. He was a family man. He was a doting and loving husband to his dear wife that he brought from Igede Ekiti, as Baba reminded me last night. Mama is smiling. This is the first time Mama is smiling in church today. Baba has been holding Mama since last night. But at the church lady, money, Baba, ewa joko si waju. Money kwe yao, fe joko si waju, fe joko ti Mama. Kwe because Mama, what is shoe Mama fan won? Pa won loko Mama sin. And we don't have a doubt Baba will look after Mama. Baba Sholaye was a loving, disciplinarian dad to his children from all accounts. Because you can see that, like they say, a foot does not fall far from a tree. One of the legacies is that a man will be described as having legacies that a man can leave in the sands of time at the impact that he made in his lifetime, the lives that he touched, the kind of things that we just described Baba achieved. These are things that termites and kankerworm can never eat. You can build a house. I don't know how many times we've driven around and remember any great man by the size of house that he's built. That this man is so great. Look at how big his house is. People just drive past the house. A generation of more will even have started nearly 30 beresi, wo 30 beresi, 30 years. But with the kind of life of impact that Baba has lived, people will go to school. Students would want to emulate him. They will read of him because his name will remain in history books. Beyond this, Baba has a legacy of beautiful children. Beautiful and successful children who in their rights have, you know, done well and are captains of industry. Yesterday I was talking to Lamide. I didn't even know that he also is a veterinary doctor. He went to school in University of Ibadan alongside with my brother-in-law, Dr. Oduye. My father-in-law was a lecturer, Professor Oduye. So these are the kind of children that Baba has. As the governor of Baba's home state, we mourn Baba on one part. At the same time, we celebrate him. My family, the entire people and government of Ogun State, our prayer is that the Almighty God will accept Baba's soul, will forgive his sins, will grant him eternal rest. We pray that same Almighty God will be with Mama, Baba's wife of, I'm sure, probably about almost 55, 60 years, 62 years, 62 years of loving him. Mama, like I prayed for you yesterday, the Almighty God will be your husband. He will be your partner. He will be your companion. He will be your friend. He will be with you. He will comfort you. And of course, Baba Batujo will assist him in doing all that. The Almighty God will be the father of your children and the grandfather to your grandchildren. As a state government, we have decided that we are going to immortalize this great man of Ogun State. We will be naming something after him. Something that people would remember him by, as someone who served this state diligently, creatively, selflessly. I will be dialoguing with Baba Basonjo on between something we are building in finance and something we are building in trade and investment. I will decide, Baba Basonjo, which of those edifices we are going to name as your Nolakpo Soleye edifice. Odun Aji Notira Won. Mama the children and Baba Eku Araferaku. Omo Asheru Efa Wa Nohun. Baba Musofila Romoni Awa No Asheru Ile Ifun Yin Gbata Ti Ko Ba To. Bo e ti de boarding gate o. E ti gba boarding pass o. So asiko yen si ma jin baba. And you confirmed to me yesterday, abi beko, pe you are still here with us for a long time. Abi beko daddy. Sir? To all those who have come to join us in bidding Baba a befitting farewell, I pray that the God Almighty will be with all of you. He will take you back home to your destination safely in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you very much for listening to me, and God bless you.
Thank you, sir. Please. Let's celebrate the governors again as you take a seat. Please let the choir be coming as we take some shots with the governor.
The end of love.
Thank you. Let's celebrate Governor once again. Family and friends, we just want to use this time to say a big thank you to the father of the state, Prince Dapo Abiodun. Can we give a big round of applause for Prince Dapo Abiodun? He's been loving and supportive of us in this place. Thank you very much, sir. thank you. The Christian sings. We'll have you again by the time you come for the Hallelujah chorus. God bless you. So the Old Baptist Church Choir. Let's celebrate them, please. Let's celebrate the Christian sings. Baba is a lover of music. And he has invested so much in the life of people in church music. Old Baptist Church Choir.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. This solo piece titled The Holy City is going to be rendered in honor of our Baba, our grandfather, our grand patron, Baba Onolapo Olusegun Soleye. May you be blessed as you listen. Last night I lay asleeping, there came a dream so fair. I stood in old Jerusalem, beside a temple there. I heard the children singing, and ever as they sung, me taught the voice of angels from heaven answer rung. Me taught the voice of angels from heaven answer rung. And then me taught my dream was changed. The streets no longer rang. Hushed were the glad hosannas. The little children sang. The sun grew dark with mystery. The morn was cold and chill as the shadow of a cross arose upon a lonely hill. As the shadow of a cross arose upon a lonely hill. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, hark how the angels sing.
the scene was changed, new earth seemed to be. I saw the holy city beside a timeless sea. The light of God was on his streets, the gates were open wide. Let all world might enter and know one was denied. No need.
Baba ma sun lo orun didun bi orun omode kekere. Hallelujah.
Yes. Oh, dúpẹ́ gbogbogbò ṣe ń bọ̀ nígbà tí a bá ti gbọ́ ọ̀rọ̀ ọlọ́run tán tí a ó jò a ó fi ayọ̀ wa hàn. Ó tó àkókò láti gbọ́ ọ̀rọ̀ ọlọ́run. À ń kí bàbá wa Reverend Dr. A.A. Adéwọlé Kábọ̀ tí wọ́n ti fìgbà kan jẹ́ olùṣọ́ àgùntàn ìjọ yìí. Ẹ jẹ́ ká ṣe àjọyọ̀ wọn please. Let's celebrate him.
Hallelujah. The two passages for this message is taken from Revelation 14:13. For those of us who have our Bibles with us, let's turn to Revelation 14:13, chapter 14, verse 13. And the second one is Ecclesiastes, chapter 12, verses 13 to 14. The first one. And I heard a voice from heaven saying, write, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord from now on. Yes, says the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors, for their deeds follow them. The second one, Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verses 13 and 14. The conclusion, when all has been heard, is fear God and keep his commandments, because this applies to every person. For God will bring every act to judgment, everything which is hidden, whether it is good or bad. Before we start this message, I want us to rise and sing Olorun to da awon oke won ni. Shall we rise? Choir.
Olorun to da awon oke yi ba ni.
Father, King of kings and the Lord of lords, the beginning and the end, the first and the last, we bless your holy name for a life well lived by our Baba, Dr. Onolapo Oluwasegun Adisa Soleye. Glory be to your holy name, for this day is a day of blessing. It's a day of thanksgiving. It's a day of giving glory and honor to you, Almighty God. And we are in your presence to listen to your word. And as I stand behind the cross, I declare your message. And I pray that let the message be a blessing to me and to everybody present here today. And glorify your name all along. Thank you, Father, for answering our prayers. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. In this message, after the introduction, I want to give us 9 points on what heaven is. And I dwell briefly on the 2 passages. And that's all. And I believe God is going to bless us. On behalf of my family, I want to commiserate with Mama Modupe Soleye, the children of Baba Soleye, the entire members of Soleye family, the members of Iriju Society, Owu Baptist Church, and Ogun State in general, for the call to glory of an icon, Baba Dr. Onolapo Adisa Soleye, who faithfully served as former Federal Minister of Finance during the military regime of General Muhammad Buhari. The Lord of all comforts, we uphold you, we console you, and we grant you all a unique fortitude to bear the irreparable loss in Jesus' mighty name. I also want to express my profound gratitude to the children of the deceased for the privilege and honor done me to come and deliver this message. God will honor you and bless you beyond your expectation and imagination in Jesus' name. With all protocols duly and humbly observed, I welcome all our dignitaries to the presence of God in this sanctuary of love and unity, Owu Baptist Church. The topic of this message God has asked for us in this service is the essence of living to make heaven. The essence of living to make heaven. From our understanding of the Holy Bible, there are 2 places meant for human beings where to spend eternity after this earthly existence. These are heaven and hell. Heaven is real, and hell is also real, according to the Bible. God, in his own prerogative, created the 2 places as a result of the fall of Lucifer from his exalted position, together with some of the angels. Isaiah 14, verses 12 to 15, Revelation 12:12. This is to distinguish between the faithful and obedient people of God and the disobedient ones in this world. The two sets of people inhabiting this perilous world include the righteous and the wicked. The righteous are meant for eternal life, which is heaven, and the wicked are meant for eternal punishment, which is hell. Jesus, in his parable of the sheep and the goats in Matthew chapter 25 and 36, declared, "And these, that is the goats and the wicked, will go away into everlasting punishment, but the righteous, the sheep, into eternal life." I sincerely believe that no one in this world, especially in this congregation today, in his or her right thinking, will ever dream of going to hell. Everybody aspires and prays to go to heaven. But going to any of these 2 places is a matter of choice. The way and manner individual lives here on earth determines our eternal destination. The topic of this message says, the essence of living to make heaven. The ultimate is heaven. And there's no doubt about that. What is heaven? Heaven is a place Jesus promised to go and prepare for his followers. For he said in John 14, the first 3 verses, that let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also. Heaven is a place of everlasting life. For the Bible says in John 3:16,
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Heaven is a place of everlasting enjoyment, where there will be no death, no more sorrow, no crying, and no more pain. Revelation 21:4. Heaven is a place where the wicked have no say, for they shall have their own part in the lake which burns with fire, and brimstone is the second death. Revelation 21:8. Heaven is a place for the repentant sinners, for God is not willing that anyone should perish, and he is giving more time for sinners in this world to repent. 2 Peter 3:9. Heaven is the eternal joyful presence of God, for in the presence of God is fullness of joy. Psalm 16:11. Heaven is where God shall personally be with his people and be their God forever. Revelation 21:3. And last, heaven is a place from where we are expecting our Savior and Lord Jesus at his second coming. For the Bible says, our citizens is in heaven, from which we also eagerly wait for the Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. Philippians 3:20. And lastly, heaven is a place of going and no return. No one goes to heaven and come back again. But the Bible says, Hebrews 9:27, and it is appointed for man to die once after this judgment. And I dwell briefly on our text. The first text says, then I heard a voice from heaven saying to me, write, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord from now on. Yes, says the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors and their works follow them. A voice from heaven is a voice from the throne of the Almighty God with the authority no human being can question. It is divinely established and unchangeable. The Holy Spirit, the great comforter, also confirmed the voice. The voice says, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord from this physical realm. Dying in the Lord is a prerequisite to making heaven. Baba Onolapo Soleye died in the Lord, and he has been called to glory. In his lifetime, he submitted the totality of his life to Jesus Christ, accepting him as his personal Savior and Lord. He lived his life in the righteousness of Christ. Jesus said that no human being can go to his Father in heaven except through him. John 14:6. Therefore, with the confession of faith of Baba Soleye in the Lord Jesus and die in the Lord, he has gone to make heaven. Hallelujah. The first and major step to take in order to make heaven is to believe and accept Jesus as personal Savior and Lord. Then you begin to live righteously to please God. Baba Onolapo Soleye lived his life righteously as a good ambassador of God. He did not disappoint God. Even in his governmental posts, he imparted lives positively. He was an encourager of success. He did encourage me when I was doing my PhD program. His words of encouragement actually helped me a lot. And also, he was a man after peaceful coexistence. Baba Onolapo is now resting peacefully with the Lord until the resurrection day. He is resting from the labors, and his work lives after him. Every one of us, one day, we are going to leave this very lost world. But when we die, where are we going? How are we living our lives? Are we living to make heaven? This is it. We are in the world today where nobody thinks of heaven. Nobody thinks of heaven. The way some people live, you will see clearly that they think here is the end. Here is not the end, though. Here is not the end. Whether we believe it or not, here is not the end. This death is a transition. We are going to leave this body, and we are going to face the judgment of God. And when God says, this is what I want, how I want you to live your life, you better live in that way, so that when you leave this friendless world, you are going to heaven. I pray that every one of us present here today, we think of going to heaven.
those of us present before God in this service today, to you take making heaven very serious. God expects us to make heaven after our sojourn in this very lost world. God is actually watching us as an individual. The way and manner we live our lives, in our relationship with God and humanity, matters most to God. The way we relate with people, the way we handle our offices, the way we handle our palaces, the way we handle our governmental posts, God is watching. And he's going to reward us accordingly. I pray that at the time we are going to receive our reward, we shall not hear, "I don't know you," in the name of Jesus. The Bible says, the eyes of the Lord are in every place, watching the evil and the good. Proverbs 15:3. Whether we believe it or not, the Creator God will hold us accountable for the way we live in this world, in our day-to-day affairs, and he will judge us accordingly. The Bible says, yes, each of us will give account of himself to God. Romans 14:12. Therefore, make sure you live to please God with the fear of God, so as to make heaven hereafter. And I want to conclude briefly with this second part of the text. The Bible says, here is my final conclusion. Fear God and obey his commandment, for this is the entire duty of man. For God will judge us for everything we do, including every hidden thing, good or bad. Every hidden thing, what we think that nobody knows about, God knows about it and is taking note of it, and is going to bring everything into judgment. Bibeli sofu agboli roya yo oni koko gbogbo oro na ni ohun ti ati gbo tele pe beru Olorun ki o si pa ofin re mo nitori Olorun yo mu gbogbo nkan ti eniyan ba se wa si idajo aserere o ase buburu o yo mu wa si idajo nibodi o ti mu wa si idajo Lorun o se pataki ke bi kokan wa ma ronu orun igbe aye ta gbe ni isin o gboro fi han wi pe a mo pe ibi ki se bi ta mo gbe lo lai lai eni kokan wa baba mo eyi baba ona lapo so leyi adisa o mo gbogbo eyi bi pe igba kan bo e gbo nkan ti o so lekan oni baba so pe akoko mi nto lati lole akoko eni kokan wo to lati lole nigba ta ba lo sile ki la ba nle idajo la gba ni abi o se omo odo rere o se pataki ise pataki ati mo gbegbe aye ti o mu wa di orun lodo Olorun ni ori oro wa so loni yi adupe lowo Olorun fun baba wa yi he actually inherited the spirit of evangelism from his mother mama adetutu soleye ni adewolu and he did the work until the end of his life. And today we can say that he is a Christian, he died as a Christian, and God has prepared a place for him where he's going to rest forever, where he's going to be rejoicing with God forever. Brethren, what shall we say about you? In your present state, are you impacting life positively or negatively? If you have been impacting people's life negatively, it's better you change now. This Baba has impacted many lives, many lives. Even my own life, he has impacted the way he talked, the way he helped, the way and manner he advised people. He has helped me. By the time we first came here, we came with a car and with a balance of 200,000. And immediately he heard about it, and the dealer was troubling us. He heard it and he called me to himself. He said, "Take the money and give to the dealer." And he paid your money. I said it was an encourager of success. Immediately he knew that I was pursuing my PhD program. He called me. He advised me. He made sure that I finished my PhD. when he was alive. And I thank God because immediately I finished, I let him know. And he was very happy. Very glad indeed. And Baba Zola here was a man who listened to correction, especially from servant of God. There was a day Baba wanted to give offering and he used his left hand. After service, I went to Baba during the week. And I asked him, I discovered that when you are giving your offering, you use your left hand. What happened? Baba said, I didn't even take either left or right. I just put it there. Ah. I said, no, you cannot give a beggar money with your left hand and he will receive it. So if you cannot give a beggar any offering and he will receive it, we should not do that one to God. And immediately he took correction. Until we left this place, Baba never used his left hand again. If he had answered me negatively, I would have concluded that he was a member of his secret court. But he didn't. He answered me as a Christian. So Baba, there is no doubt that Baba was a Christian. And I want to challenge the children, please, for God's sake, all the legacy we have said about Baba, please imbibe it. Imbibe it. Let it reflect in your life. Let people see that, yes, this is typical Onola Kosuleye in your behavior. Mama, the grace is sufficient for you. He will strengthen you. He will uphold you. Whatever you need, he will provide it. And you will never weep over any of your children and your grandchildren. In the name of Jesus. You will never weep on any of your in-laws. In the name of Jesus Christ. Every day, God will strengthen you. Every day, he will uphold you. Every day, he will comfort you. Every day, he will make sure that you continue to rejoice in him. He will remain your strength. When you go out, remain your strength when you come in. And you have every cause to glorify God. I want to thank God for this service. And I pray, what matters most to me is that everyone present here today will be thinking of heaven. And begin to live to please God every day of your life. I pray it will be so in Jesus' name. Shall we pray? Heavenly Father, I've delivered the message you sent me. And I know you have made people to hear it. I pray that you continue to water it in the minds of everyone present here today. So that everyone will know and continue to live in a way that will make them to make heaven. In the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, may you continue to uphold Mama. May you continue to uphold the children. And continue to make sure that you enable them by your grace to live to please you in their lifetime. And I pray that you continue to strengthen this church for your glory. Continue to be with the pastor, continue with the pastors, continue to be with the deacons, continue to be with everyone in this church. So that on the last day, nobody will be missing. When Jesus Christ will appear, we shall all be raptured together to him. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Son, the Holy Spirit. May your name be praised forever. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen. Amen. It's time for Thanksgiving. Our time is fast spent. But in the midst of all this, we want to say thank you to our able Lord. And our thanksgiving will be in two phases. While we are coming in, the ushers will have given us an envelope along with the pamphlet. It's our practice here, whenever we come together like this, we still take time to partner with the church in whatever special projects the church is undertaking. To the sweet memory of our Baba, we want to cheerfully, first of all, load the envelope we are having with whatever we deem fit to honor the Lord through Baba. While the choir is giving us some lyrics, the ushers will go around with the offering plates to collect these loaded envelopes. After this, we proceed to Thanksgiving proper. Baba and our distinguished guests to come forward. After dropping our substance, Baba and others can go back, but the children will remain to see all who have come to grace the event with us. While the children are here, those of us at the gallery will come first. Then those at the basement, followed by those of us in the church. Please, the ushers will direct us. Our request is, let us defer all greetings till when we meet at the reception. And as much as possible, we want to use the central aisle. We return left or right according to where we are seated. God bless you and keep you graciously in Jesus' name. So while the choir is giving us lyrics, the ushers will go around to collect our cheerfully loaded envelopes towards other developments in the church.
Oh, she'll be right. Sorry.
Amen. On behalf of the President of Nigerian Baptist Convention, the Reverend Dr. Israel Adelani Akanji, and on behalf of all the Baptist family in Ogun State, our condolences to Mama, to all the children, to the Church of God. We pray that God will comfort you in the name of Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Lord, we are grateful for the life that Baba lived on earth. Thank you for Mama Suleye. We pray that, Lord, you will comfort her. You will grant her longevity. You will grant her peace of mind. You will grant her good health. Joy unlimited shall be your portion. And you will hear good news throughout your time on earth in the name of Jesus Christ. For the children, Heavenly Father, you will be their father. Amen. You will keep them in unity. Amen. They will experience progress in all areas of their lives. Amen. And you will also grant them longevity in Jesus' name. Amen. For the entire family, we pray that God will be your strength. Amen. God will be your joy. Amen. And the gate of evil will not come near you in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Lord, we pray that all of us will grant us grace to serve you to the end of our lives. So that the hand of it will enter your kingdom. Blessed be the name of the Lord. We pray for the Church of God, that the church will continue to experience progress and peace in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father, for answering our prayers. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Our Baba, Oloye Olusegun Obasanjo, ati awon old boys will come to pay the last respect.
We just want to say, Baba.
Your Excellency, Chief Olusegun Obasanjo, Your Excellency, Atumba Gbenga Daniel. Dr. Suleye is synonymous with the Baptist Boys High School, Abeokuta. Just look at the back of your pamphlet. You would see the picture there wearing our school cap when it was conferred with as the Distinguished Old Boy of the Year 2009. Our tribute is contained on page 62. Because of Chief Olusegun Obasanjo, Dr. Shule, which we have had to change our school anthem. We are no longer a blessing shining over Abeokuta and Nigeria. We shine all over the world. In that wise, we would sing the first and the last verses of our school anthem in tribute to one of our shining lights. From Ego, Baptist Boys High School, we are proud of thee. Oh, thy process of metamorphosis is a blessing shining all over the world. Forever and ever, verse 4. Baptist Boys High School has a pledge to thee. Thy souls and joy shall surely be ours. We will never do what can cause a shame to thy precious name, Baptist Boys High School. Forever and ever we will help you. We will uphold all the great ideals. Nulli secundus. Thank you very much.
Chaplain gbe microphone wa ba mi oni won ti gbohun mi oni akoko ti lo ati pe gbogbo awon to ti soro bi eni ti wọ́n gba ọ̀rọ̀ sọ látọ̀dọ̀ mi ni pàápàá jùlọ Abimbola all I will say is that I concur pẹ̀lú gbogbo nǹkan tó sọ pa bàbá yìí but I want to make one correction and you will say ah ọkùnrin ìtúndé o you are right for quite some time I didn't know whether Babalola was a Marxist a communist until after I left public office as head of state and some of my friends in America invited me to come to America and one of those friends was Andy Young. So Balola and I decided, I think it's about 14 days. Young had no money because he's pastor, but he had great connection. And he used his connection to facilitate our visit. The two of us. And we were going from place to place, commercial flight, private plane, and all that. And then we were, I think the last part of our visit was Palm Beach. And I don't know how many of you have been to Palm Beach before. It's heaven on earth. So, and the reception made for us, the hotel was 10 star, if there can be a hotel called 10 star. So when we landed, we were received with a special vehicle. We were taken to this hotel, and I was taken to my room. Babalola was taken to his room. It wasn't up to 30 minutes. Babalola came from his room to my room. I said, Baba Yabo. I said, yes. He said, this is great. I said, yes. I don't know that they will do this for us. He said, well, thinking about it, a little bit of money is not a bad idea after all. Then I said, oh, until today, I've always thought that you are a communist. But if you now see that a little bit of money is not a bad idea, maybe your position is not fully to the left. Maybe you are like the heart, slightly to the left, and we laugh about it. Really, he was not a communist. He was not a Marxist. He was a socialist, somebody with social conscience, and he definitely was that. Well, it now remains for me to thank you. You workers in the vineyard of God, and you, Lamide has, because I asked him to quickly thank the governor and the minister before they left. We couldn't actually say thank you to former governor Ibikunle Amosu, but we will be saying that to him. Governor Gwenga Daniel, we thank you. I want to thank the choir. The Old Baptist Church Choir, thank you for the two renditions that you have given. Really, really, very inspiring. And Christian Singh, we thank you for coming all the way from Lagos and do all this great honor. Of course, I did it too. I know that is behind this in a lot of way. I want to, in thanking Baptist Boys High School old boys, I just want to say something. All that has been said about Dr. Shuleya is correct. Simplicity, honesty, patriotism, and all that. But he didn't bring that from heaven. He got it here on earth. And Baptist Boys High School, Baptist Day School here, and Baptist Boys High School were the sources where he acquired, or we have those qualities inculcated in him. So all of us of that time who have the opportunity to go to BBHS. And for some of us, day school and BBHS. Lami Day, I was asking if any of you went to BBHS. You haven't gone to any good school. Because if you haven't gone to BBHS, you haven't gone to a good school. It's BBHS and others. But on a serious note, somebody said challenge. I won't say challenge. I will say you have a good legacy and something that you can be proud of. I am very proud of your father and my association with him. Very proud of him. May his soul rest in perfect peace.
Let's put our hands together for our Baba. Let me say once again, you are welcome to this program, the celebration of life for our Baba, late Dr. Onolapo Olusegun Soleye. And let me also inform us that this program is live on All Nations for Christ Baptist Church TV, Roku TV, Apple TV, Fire TV, iScience TV, Facebook, YouTube, and Crystal GM Radio on Zeno.fm, Radio.net, Turner Radio, and on the website of Crystal GM, which is www.crystalgm.org. Crystal GM is spelled as CHRTOGA. And this is sponsored by Reverend Peter Ademosho. Once again, I want to greet our mama and the children. And as we are praying, the Lord will continue to comfort the family and uphold you in Jesus' mighty name. And also we want to extend our greeting to the larger Soleye family, the Olaleye and the Adewolu families. I want to appreciate the coming of our Baba, Chief Olusegun Obasanjo, GCFR, the former president of Nigeria, and our mama, Chief Mrs. Bola Obasanjo. And we also appreciate the coming of the governor, His Excellency Prince Dapo Abiodun CON, the governor of Ogun State, and also the Honorable Minister for Finance and Coordinating Minister of the Economy, Mr. Wale Edun. And we also appreciate His Excellency Senator Otumba Gbenga Daniel, the former governor of Ogun State, here present. And we also appreciate the coming of His Excellency Senator Ibikunle Amosun, the former governor of Ogun State, and the senator representing Ogun Central, Senator Shuaib Afolabi Salisu, and also His Excellency Alhaji Sharaf Atuji Ishola, the former ambassador to United Kingdom, and the other state delegates that have been part of the program. Also, we want to appreciate the representative of our KBSS, the Alake and the paramount ruler of Egbaland, Oba Michael Aremogbadebo, led by Honorable Bode Mustafa, the Boba Gunwa of Egbaland, OC of Egbaland. Also the representative of Olowu of Owo Kingdom, Obasaka Matemilola, the Oshupori of Owo, Chief Adeoye, Chief Olushola Adeoye, and other Owo chiefs here present. Also, we want to appreciate the coming of the representative of our KBSC, Oba Adewale Teju Osho, the Oshile of Okeono. We have our mamas here, the Oloris. You are most welcome, huh? Also, we want to recognize Chief Niyi Adegbenro, the OC of Owo Kingdom. Also, we want to recognize our Baba in the house here, Baba Doja Adewolu and Mama Adewolu. You are welcome. You are welcome, son and ma. We also want to recognize engineer, Deacon Engineer Enne Oyedele and Mama Oyedele. Also, we recognize Engineer Wole Adebayo. Also, we recognize Commissioner Leke Adewolu and Chief Shino Gudimu. We also recognize Engineer Tukumbo Odebome, the Chairman of Ogun State Civil Service Commission. And we also recognize members of Abeokuta Club. And also recognize the Egbe Afadura Jagun Onigbagbo. We appreciate your coming. As I've been announced to us, the interment and reception is strictly by invitation, and arrangements have been made for society in the church and all members of the church that your reception will be taken care within the church premises. I want to appreciate our officiating ministers. Let me start with the conference president, Reverend Dr. Oyewale Oyeniyi. You are most welcome, sir. Also, the former pastor of the church, Reverend Dr. A.A. Adewale. The moderator, Abeokuta South Baptist Association, Reverend D.S.O. Tinu Oye. And our own church pastor here, Reverend Josiah Adesope. The youth and outreach pastor, Reverend Francis Mukoro, and the chairman, Diaconate Ball, Deacon Dr. J.A.K. Omoyimi. We want to appreciate you for coming. Thank you, and God bless you.
Because of our time, we want to make some adjustments in our program now. We'll be taking the vote of thanks, then we'll take the closing prayer and benediction, after which we are going to take the Hallelujah chorus. So, vote of thanks, please. The family said they would like to hear the voice of our Baba, Reverend Dr. Dotson Sholeye. Please let's celebrate him before the final vote of thanks.
Thank you. Praise the Lord. I'm not going to waste your time. Two or three people sent me to Auntie, Professor Shola and Fani Akingbala, Professor Funso Akingbala, and Brashola Olaleye. And personally, on behalf of my own family, my wife could not be here, our children, KG, Doyin, Ojo, and Mabel. Fortunately, this is a small world. Bimbo and KG, they met after 35 years in, where did you meet Bimbo? Because of prayer and the two photographs. I think they were the same year. So this is normal, and I'm happy to be here. Now, the closing. I want all of us to stand up. This the song that my daddy, my uncle, Dr. Nolakpo Olusegun Adisa Soleye is now singing in heaven. And he wants all of you to join in singing, especially the chorus. So 9:44 in your Sankey. I will sing the first stanza. We will sing the second stanza. Then I'm going. I'm done with my 9:44. Hey, Sankey. Oh, come on, Sankey, Lano. I did. Okay, I'm going to sing this song. Uncle taught me this song in 1961. At 1960, before he left for America. Afrishtaland, that's what he's telling you, all of you. Afrishtaland of coins and wine, and all his riches freely mine. Yeah, shines on thee one blissful day, for my night has passed away. Oh, Beulah land, sweet Beulah land. Thank God that our uncle is there, and my prayer is that one day all of us, by the special grace of God, will join him and my nephew Lola and all those that have gone before us. God bless you. Stay back, stick to your destination in Jesus' name. Thank you.
Thank you very much, family. I will make this short and snappy. Let me say it first in Yoruba. Beje wa pon onolapo soleye le. Oluwa pon yin le loruko Jesu. Beje wa ye wa si. Oluwa ye yin si. I'll make it simple in English. As you have all sacrificed your time, this event started on Wednesday through to Thursday, and today, the weekday event. As you've honored Onoshole and as you've honored the family, I pray that the Lord bestows honor on all of you. And for every hand that has been stretched out, with your presence, with presence, with gifts, with the blessing, may the Lord bless you abundantly. Thank you very much, and God bless you.
Shall we pray? Dear Eternal Father, we are really very grateful unto you for taking absolute control of these programs since Wednesday that we started. Father, be glorified in the name of Jesus. As we continue to go to the grave site, we pray you will take control. At the reception, you will take absolute control. We pray, O Lord, that you will grant everyone turning mercy back home in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Eternal Father. Continue to be with the family. Continue to be with the church. Continue to be with all of us. And at the end of everything here on earth, eternal life will be our reward. In Christ's name we pray.
We rise as I say the benediction. Let's rise up as I say the benediction. And may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. And the church of God will say a better amen. The congregation will sit down, and when they sing, when we get to King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the congregation will rise. That's our tradition.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Now we'll take Hallelujah Chorus. The tradition is to stand midway, King of Kings. However, in the beginning, it was not so. So the moment you hear Hallelujah, which is singing Hallelujah to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, we all rise. We don't sing Hallelujah across sitting down. Aki Kioba Nijoko. So we start. Hallelujah, the first Hallelujah, we all rise. I want to invite everyone before us to please rise as we take Hallelujah across.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. For our recessional hymn shall be found in the Baptist Hymnal 491. Let's turn our pamphlets to page 6. Now thank we all our God with hearts and hands and voices.
Thank you. Yeah, thank you everybody on Zoom and on the televisions, all the five televisions in the world, and you people listening to us on radio.net in Europe and Zeno.fm in North and South America. You people on Facebook and YouTube, that was the service of our dear father, Dr. Onolapo Olusegun Adisa Soleye. We should have loved to show you the interment, but because of we were told by the family that the interment will be private, and I will let you know in another few, about 1 hour, we'll go get you to the reception. So on behalf of our studio, All Nations for Christ Baptist Church studio from London, we want to say thank you so much for bearing with us with all the Nigerian palavers and all other things. We are glad to have you, and we love to have you too. Peradventure, you have any wonderful programs, we love to be a channel to you, or have any to hear to the world. Thank you so, so much. In about 1 hour plus, please, we would like you to join us for the reception. For the interment, we may not be able to do that. That is information from the family. Thank you. And God bless you.
Hello, Bodafella. This is just to seize this opportunity to thank you every time for all you do back home, especially for us that we are away, that you always make us to join this kind of services. Thank you so, so much. The Lord will help you. The Lord will bless you.
Thank you, bro.
This is Yemisi. Yemisi.
I know.
Adebayo Ilori.
You don't need to describe yourself. Your voice. I'm about to bring Ghana. One casting becomes me. The public of Bayaladi. God bless you. We are there. Thank you so much. God bless you. I'll see you in another about 1 hour. Then we'll be able to have the reception. I will get across to you. And you people can join us for now. Wale Shoroye, thank you for coming. And Shosho, all the Shoroye is there. God bless you. Thank you very much. We are going off the air for a few minutes. Bye.